Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we have a topic, cash flow versus net income, and we are going to study what are some of the key differences with the help of supporting examples. The first and the foremost what we are going to look at is the graph that is visible in front of us, that is Amazon's cash from operations and Amazon.com's. So in the blue line, which indicates Amazon's cash from operations, which is 16.44 billion, and Amazon's net income, which is 2.371 billion. So this is the difference between the cash flow from the operations and the net income. But we will try and look at a bigger picture here. The Amazon's net income, which is visible to us, $2.37 billion, and the cash flow from the CFS ops, that is operation, 16.44 billion. So why there is a difference between the two? See, cash flow and net income, they both are the two key factors in judging whether the company has been doing well or not. But how can we relate to each other? So in this tutorial, we'll have a look at both the cash flows and net income to make sense of how they work. Now, first and the foremost thing, what are cash flows? Now, cash flow statement is completely different than that of the income statement. Let's take an example to understand this. A company has, let's say, made a revenue of $200 in, let's say, 2016. And the expenses they have incurred, let's say, is 110. So that means the net profit over here is standing at 200 minus 110, that's 90. But if you look at from the point of view of the cash flow statement, we need to consider the cash inflow and cash outflow. So the company's cash inflow was 170, that didn't collect the whole amount in 2016, and the cash outflow was standing at 90, and the rest of the amount would be paid in 2017. So the net cash flow is standing at 170 minus 90, that's 80. So it has been proven that even if the company made a profit of 90, its net cash flow is going to be 80. And there lies an importance of the cash flow statement. So the cash flow statement helps an investor to recognize the cash inflow and cash outflow of the company so that they don't get allured by the hefty profits and revenue. Now, it has often been seen that the net cash flow is negative for a company even after earning a whooping profit. So without looking at the cash flow statement, an investor cannot conclude about the performance of a company year by year basis. Now, second, what is net income? See, profit or net income is the bottom line of the income statement of the company. So to ascertain the profit or net income, a company needs to set up an income statement and find out the net balance of income and expenses. So this income and expenses are reported because the transactions have been done, whether or not the cash has been paid or received. Actually has been paid or received. So in the next section, we will see how to set up a cash flow statement, direct and indirect method both, and income statement to a certain degree. First, we'll see the cash flow from the operations format, and we'll also look at the format of the indirect method of cash flow statement along with the example. As it is directly related to the net income, then we'll look at the format of the net income. If the computation, we are going to see the computation of the cash flow from the operating activities. As you can see, this is the format of cash and cash equivalent and operating activities. There's a net income here. You make various adjustments to this. You add back all the non-cash expenditures, stock-based compensations, that's ESOPs, other operating expenses, other expenses, and deferred incomes. All this are been added back or deducted, and then the change has been taken care of. So this is the net income linked to the cash flow statement. And what exactly causes the difference between the net income and the cash flow from operation is this particular part. This is going to be added up. But again, all these changes are going to change this number, right? So you can see in this example that we started with the net income and then made all the adjustments mentioned above. And non-cash items like depreciation, amortization, stock-based compensations are added back. Likewise, changes in the operating assets and liabilities like inventories, account receivables, accounts payables, and others. Now this is basically the indirect method, but in case of the direct method, you directly start with the gross sales and you start deducting things. So there is no sort of this adjustment thing is made. So this is for the indirect method, but for the direct method, you just start deducting things, you know, on a direct basis. There are things called positive cash flows and net incomes. So, you know, I'm going to give you some of the example of the top companies with the positive cash flows and the positive net income. See, this is the list of the positive cash flows and positive net incomes. We start with the Toyota Motors, Wells Fargo, Alphabet, Bank of America. See the market cap. And everything is in terms of millions. The cash flow from the operations and the net incomes. So market cap then follows the operations and then follows the net income. So what we note down here is that, you know, Microsoft is having the highest level of market cap. The CFOs are maximum for Toyota Motors. And the net income is highest when we talk about Wells Fargo. So these are the three companies that are leading in terms of such drivers, that is the market cap, CFOs, and net income. Right. Now I'm going to show you in terms of negative cash flow. This are some of the example of the top companies with negative cash flows or negative net incomes. See, for the Tesla, Nokia, Symantec, other companies, you see the market cap, the CFOs are negative. See, like Tesla, no, Nokia failed badly. There was no doubt in that. And the net incomes are also flowing in terms of negative. In spite of having the high market caps, as you can see, it's 51,449 million. The rest are still below the bottom line. But in spite of being a high market cap, the CFOs and their net incomes are low. So you can imagine what impact can it have on the investors or as a stakeholder as a whole. Now, there are some positive cash flows and negative net incomes examples that I'll show you. Now, these are some of the examples where there are some of the companies where the top companies with positive cash flows and negative net incomes, like Vodafone, BHP, First Energy, Hess, Petrobras, and so on and so forth. You see the market caps, you see the CFOs, the net incomes are negative. The CFOs, as you can see, they are considerably good in terms of the market cap. See over here, 302,403, and there is negative amount here. So there is always going to be a vast difference in terms of various other companies. Now I'll show you an examples of negative cash flows and positive net incomes. Now, this are the example of the negative cash flows and the net incomes are positive. In the previous case, this was positive and net income was negative. So UBS Bank having the cash flow from operations as negative. You see the highest market cap of UBS Bank. CFOs are negative, but the net income is positive. And it goes with every other company. Like, you know, see the General Electric, the highest market cap of 227,086 as the market cap, having a 244 negative and 8831 as a part of net income. So this is how things are going to go. Finally, I'll make my conclusion on this, that the basic difference between the net income and the net cash flow is, like, you know, first of all, in all the cases, the net income, it does not matter whether the transactions in cash or not. That means that when the net income and the revenues are reported on the income statement, when they are earned, but in the case of the cash flow statement, we only deal with the cash and cash equivalents, like how much cash comes in and how much cash goes out during the period. Again, you know, some expenses which are considered in the income statement, like debt amortization, are not actually cash expenses, but still are deducted from the revenue. And in the cash and cash statement, they should be added back to the net income to have no effect on the cash flow. And third and the final thing is that, you know, in case of the net income, even the profits and losses and other sources like consolidated income statement, they are considered. But in the cash, like, you know, case of the cash flow statement, they don't add or reduce the cash. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.